The time is 7:45 a.m. What, that's what the clock says? The rest of it, I'm just reading the clock. It's 5 o'clock somewhere, right? This is my stuff. Okay. Good morning, everybody. The meeting can get started now that PennDOT has shown up. We appreciate you coming to today's meeting. They're running a little late, and they just want us to do anything without them. So we call today's meeting of the House Transportation to order. The meeting is being broadcast and recorded. Blade, can you please take roll call?
Chairman Nielsen.
Here.
Representatives Bellman. Curry.
Leave.
Owenstein.
Here.
Markosik.
Designation.
McAndrew. McNeil. Mullins. Here. O'Mara.
Designation.
Piscitano.
Designation.
Rossi. Schusterman. Siegel. Warren.
Designation.
Chairman. Here online.
Here online.
Chairman Benninghoff.
Here.
Representatives Cabell. Devonzo. Labs. Ortitai. Shurin. Schmidt. Smith.
Present.
Stambaugh.
Present.
Struzzi. Warner. Quorum is present.
The first item on our agenda is House Resolution 174, introduced by Representative James Struzzi. I move to consider Resolution 174. Is there a second? Chairman Benninghoff. Larissa, could you please give us a summary of the resolution?
House Resolution 174, sponsored by Representative Struzzi, would direct the Legislative Budget and Finance Committee to conduct a study and issue a report on the state of mass and public transit in Pennsylvania's rural communities. In addition to assessing the existing rural mass and public transit infrastructure, the LBFC would be compelled to develop and issue a comprehensive set of recommendations and strategies on how to improve rural transit systems moving forward. LBFC's report must be submitted to the PA House of Representatives within 12 months after the adoption of this resolution.
Thank you, Larissa. I ask the members to support the resolution, and I ask Representative Struzzi if he has any comments he would like to have for the record.
Yes, thank you, Mr. Chairman. I do appreciate the Transportation Committee taking up this important resolution. We have great rural public transportation right now in Indigo, but they themselves can't meet all the unmet needs. And this really came to my attention during a recovery simulation that I participated in, where you had to take a morning and we all played the role of someone with a substance abuse disorder. And you had to go through a day in the life of someone trying to get to their appointments, trying to get to work, trying to do their court-appointed things that they had to do during the day. And if you miss the bus in the morning, you weren't going to get that done. And then you're back to the beginning again. You're violating your probation. You're violating your court orders. You're going to lose your job. You could lose custody of your kids, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. And that really brought the issue to my attention on how important it is that we provide transportation, not just for people in recovery, but for people in rural areas that maybe can't get to work because they don't have a vehicle. Senior citizens who can't get to the grocery store or their medical appointments. And you can tell all sorts of stories that would relate to the lack of transportation for these individuals. So that's why I think this resolution is so important, that we identify where those gaps are and identify solutions to help people get to the basic essentials of life. So I appreciate, again, the Transportation Committee taking up this resolution, and I ask for your support.
Thank you, Representative. Are there any comments or questions on the resolution? Representative McNeil.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Representative Struzzi, I want to thank you on this legislation. For 16 years, I worked with students, adult students with disabilities, and part of my job was teaching them how to ride public transit and to apply for jobs. And sadly, the ones that lived in the rural area had much less opportunity to get a job because of all the obstacles they had trying to get around in public transportation. Thank you.
Thank you, Representative McNeil. Any other comments or questions? Representative Hohenstein.
Thank you, Chair. And I'm also going to say thank you to Representative Struzzi. The idea of making sure we are doing all we can to lift up what is going on for mass transit everywhere in the state is essential, because any of the actual resolutions that we make on transit funding have to include rural communities as well as, you know, the urban communities that I come from, the suburbs. It doesn't happen in a vacuum, and it doesn't happen with one singular bill or policy. And I know the chairman both understand that very well, and I appreciate you bringing this up.
Thank you, Representative. Any other comments or questions? Are there any negative votes on House Resolution 174? Seeing none, House Resolution 174 is unanimously reported as committed. On a little side note, that is my district number, just in case anybody was wondering why we ran that. Yeah. So, lucky Jim.
Whatever it takes.
Well, the next one. The next item on today's agenda is House Resolution 236, introduced by Chairman Representative Doyle Heffley. I move to consider House Resolution 236. Is there a second? Chairman Benninghoff. Kyle, I twisted his arm there. You saw that, right? Yeah. Can you please give a summary of the resolution?
Thank you. House Resolution 236 by Representative Heffley directs the Joint State Government Commission to conduct a comprehensive study on truck parking in Pennsylvania. The Pennsylvania Transportation Advisory Committee has identified a shortfall of approximately 4,400 truck parking spaces across the Commonwealth, which leaves roughly 1,000 trucks parked on highway shoulders and ramps on a typical night. By conducting a study on the Commonwealth's truck parking shortage, the Joint State Government Commission can highlight inadequacies of Pennsylvania's truck parking infrastructure and gather data and recommend innovative strategies to increase the Commonwealth's designated truck parking capacity.
Thank you, Kyle. I ask the members to support the resolution, and I recognize Chairman Doyle Heffley for some comments.
Thank you, Chairman Nielsen and Chairman Benninghoff for considering this resolution. I mean, we all see it. We all travel on the highways and the interstates, and you see the trucks parked on the shoulder of the road. Drivers are bound by their Federal Motor Carrier Safety Administration, the hours of service, when they have to take their breaks. I think it's an issue that is multi-leveled. I mean, we're looking at driver shortages across the country and here in Pennsylvania. We're the Keystone State. Like, all the traffic comes through our corridor, going to the Northeast, going to the rest of the country. We want to give these drivers a dignity to be able to park somewhere safe to take their 10-hour break. I mean, somewhere they have access, hopefully, to facilities to wash their hands and use the bathroom, maybe grab a bite to eat. But aside from that, just somewhere to safely park, not along the interstate, where they can get a good night's rest so they can get out there and do their job. So I really I thank you, and I think it's important that we look at what all the options are and how we can help this industry to be a little bit safer on the highways.
Thank you, Chairman. Are there any questions or comments on House Resolution 236? Chairman Benninghoff?
That number that you stated that are currently available in the shortfall, does that also include those that would be a double trailer? They delineated out some other way.
No, you're looking at power, like it would be power units. I believe that's how the study would, I would assume. You're only looking at whether that, you know, you could have a 44-foot flatbed trailer or a 48-foot trailer or a 53-foot trailer, depending on the length of each individual unit. But it's the individual cab that has to park, and that's where the driver, you know, if they're an over-the-road driver, is going to have to take their time off.
Thank you, Chairman. Representative Smith.
Thank you, Chairman. Thank you, Representative Heffley, for bringing this resolution forward. As a prior... In my former life, a trucking company owner, I knew my drivers, and even when I was out driving, that was an issue, was finding a parking spot. In today's world, with the electronic logs and having to plan your day and get to some point, when you got to the end of your driving day, it wasn't guaranteed you would find a truck, a place to park your truck. So it's very important that we do this study and hopefully help the truckers out in Pennsylvania and the truckers traveling through. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Representative. Any other comments or questions on House Resolution 236? Seeing none, are there any negative votes? Seeing no negative votes, this resolution passes and will be reported out of committee. Thank you, Representative, for coming. The next item on the agenda is House Resolution 248, introduced by Representative Christine Howard. I move to consider this resolution 248. Is there a second? Representative McNeil. Kyle, can you please give a summary of the resolution? The other Kyle. Don't get excited. We got a lot of Kyles here now. Kyle 1, Kyle 2, Kyle 3.
House Resolution 248 by Representative Christine Howard. This resolution recognizes October 15th, 2023 as White Cane Safety Day in Pennsylvania. It further acknowledges the need to educate the public about the use of white canes and guide dogs to keep pedestrians with impaired vision safe and independent.
Thank you, Kyle. I ask the members to support the resolution. Are there any comments or questions on House Resolution 248? Seeing none, are there any negative votes on House Resolution 248? No. Seeing none, House Resolution 248 is unanimously reported as committed. We will now proceed to any other business before the committee. The last item on our agenda is House Bill 1798, introduced by Representative Frank Burns. I move to consider House Bill 1798. Is there a second? Representative Hohenstein. Kyle, can you please give a summary of the bill?
House Bill 1798 by Representative Frank Burns. This bill designates a bridge in Cambria Township, Cambria County, as the Michael G. Sicalis Memorial Bridge. Michael G. Sicalis enlisted in the United States Navy during World War II and was assigned to an amphibious land cruiser, which was one of the first ships to land on Omaha Beach during D-Day. After the war, he served for more than 20 years as mayor of Ebensburg Borough and Cambria County, and as Cambria County Prothonotary. He passed away on May 18th, 2022, and there is one amendment.
Thank you. I offer Amendment A02777. I move to adopt Amendment A02777. Is there a second? Chairman Benninghoff. Kyle, will you please give a summary of the amendment?
Amendment A02777 makes a technical change to the placement of signs for the existing Charles J. Vicini Memorial Bridge in Cambria Township, Cambria County. The prime sponsor this amendment is agreed to by the prime sponsor.
Are there any comments or questions on the amendment? Seeing none, are there any negative votes on Amendment A02777? Seeing none, Amendment A02777 is unanimously adopted. Are there any comments or questions on House Bill 1798 as amended? Are there any negative votes on House Bill 1798 as amendment? Seeing none, House Bill 1798 is unanimously reported as amended. Now, prior to we adjourn, we have a couple new people in here that new to the TV cameras here. Yeah, you're first, Kyle. Go ahead. Let them know what you do and who you are and all that neat stuff.
Hello, my name's Kyle Schaefer. I've been with the House Research Department for about 2 years. Was originally on State Government Committee and Local Government Committee. In my personal time, I'm a Civil War reenactor, so I'm a nerd. So,
welcome. We like nerds. Okay, Nielsen has a couple on his crew, too. Go ahead, peeps, you got it. Newbies.
Hello, I'm Evan Sobolewski. I'm a legislative assistant for Representative Ed Nielsen. I'm glad to be here.
Very good, quick and easy.
Hi, everyone. I'm Mackenzie Hansard. I'm also a legislative assistant for Representative Ed Nielsen.
All right. Well, welcome. They are both staff. Yes, they were both. This way we can get more stuff done in our committee. We're not doing enough. We're only the highest in the Commonwealth here in the House of Representatives. We're not getting enough done. All right. Motion to adjourn is made by Chairman Benninghoff, and I will second. And everybody have a wonderful day.